Good afternoon and welcome to the Amie Jo Show. Hi, this is Amie Jo, and I've got a special treat for all my listeners today and also for you that are viewing on the internet, in the studio, live and in living color. I have the honor to bring to you the dynamic musical duo, Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis. If you've ever had a question about the music industry or wanted to know what it's going to take to become a musical icon, you better listen up and listen very closely, because these gentlemen are going to take us on their personal journey to musical success. And if you're just about to get out of your car, you don't need to miss this show, because we're streaming live and being heard around the world right now at www.klav1230am.com.
To come to this. Well, I'm back, but this time I'm with my man. And these women are putting their hands all over his Yamamoto Kanzai sweater that I bought. And I'm much, much unhappy about that. I'd hate to come down to the level and become a BW, a basic woman. But if they don't stop, it's gonna get scandalous.
Welcome back. You're listening to the Amie Jo Show, and it's all about entertainment today. We're not meeting in the ladies' room, but we are in the studio with the dynamic duo of the music industry, Mr. Jimmy Jam and Mr. Terry Lewis. They've gone where few others have gone before. And to their credit, they're the only contemporary producers to produce number one hits in three consecutive decades, in the 80s, the 90s, and all the way into the new millennium. Good afternoon, gentlemen. Thank you for being here.
Thanks for having us, Amie.
Yes.
Oh, you know what? Before we went on the air, I said there's so much in my head that I want to talk about, that I want to say about you guys, because what you've done is just short of really remarkable. Do you feel that way about yourselves?
No, not really. I think we just take it day by day, and we think we get to work with a lot of remarkable people.
Mm.
And they make us look real good, so we
they
take
make
more
you
like
look
that.
At wow, humility and modesty. I mean, that's a great attribute, but
as I said before, we talked off air a little bit. It's just blessings. Mm-hmm. It really is. We're just honored and blessed and feel privileged to do what we do. We get to make a living doing something that we would be doing down our basements, just as a hobby, you know. But we get to actually make a living doing it, and that mm-hmm. is the ultimate, gift to be able to do that.
Yeah. And Terry, do you feel that way?
Absolutely. It's definitely a blessing. I feel like we've been very blessed to live a dream. And, hopefully it never turns into a nightmare.
Uh-oh.
You get the wrong artist and they can do that.
That's true.
But thankfully
well, wait a minute. Let's stop there for a moment.
Okay.
Because you guys have had so much success with virtually every person that you've worked with. And over this interview, we're going to talk about a lot of those people. But how can a bad artist ruin you? You're the guys who produce it. You write the lyrics. You put the music together. What could the artist do to make it go bad for you?
Well, they can make it work. You know, it's fun.
Oh, okay.
And an artist that comes in with maybe a closed mind or a bad attitude makes it feel like work.
Okay.
You know, and you can do things in a number of different ways in terms of creative. Usually we like to do things based on inspiration.
Mm.
And then you can do it the other way, which is the other extreme, just doing it on know-how.
Okay.
So we can do it both ways, but we prefer inspiration. So people that come and inspire you, you know, they're nice, they're kind,
yeah.
They're very creative, they're very open to creativity, other creativity, and collaborating with collaborative people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that makes it really easy and fun.
Okay.
And on the other hand, that other person would be the guy that would just not, or girl, that just wouldn't want to collaborate, didn't want to try anything new, just knew what they wanted and it was the wrong thing.
Mm.
And they could make it feel like work. Okay, we'll do a 8-bar verse and a 16-bar hook, or
you know, my analogy for that would be, it's like a bad date.
Yes.
You know, you go on good dates. You know, you see a person, you talk to them a little bit. You think, oh, this would be nice to go on an actual date.
Yeah.
And you get on the date, and then you realize, oh, man, what did I do? I just can't wait to get out of this. And so working with a bad artist or someone where the chemistry isn't right, that's what that's like. So what we try to do is beforehand, we try to really get a sort of a background check and kind of know. Terry calls it hang factor. Are these people that we would just hang out with whether we were working with them or not?
Okay.
And if the hang factor's right, then we know we're in good shape.
Mm. You get that feeling sometimes with someone like that. It's like, sure, that's not your bus.
Yeah, exactly.
That's not your bus number coming in. You got somewhere to go.
Time to leave.
Yeah.
Right? Well, do you ever do just a single for someone, or is it always like a full CD?
We do singles, but we much prefer to do, you know, more than that. You know, sometimes it's 2 songs, 3 songs, whatever. But what happens is doing one song, it's almost like an assignment. It's almost like come up with a hit song. And I think it's better when a hit comes organically. If you do 2 or 3 songs, then to me you're increasing your chances, but also the process of doing it is now, you know, we don't feel a pressure to come up with one hit. We just do 3 songs, and one of them is inevitably going to be, or at least knock on wood so far with us, comes up to be a hit. So it's usually better to do that. We prefer to do that.
Okay.
And you get to know an artist. Like I say, it's like a relationship. So if it's a good relationship, you don't want one date.
Mm-hmm.
You want to continue that relationship further.
You want to go down the road.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're working on a song, what is about the amount of time for just a single, not the entire CD? Because you're talking about spending time with people. You're also saying, sometimes you don't want to, but like they wrote the check and you're like, okay, whatever you want. How long does it take to really do a song? Because you've got like 14 or 15 number one hits.
16.
Okay.
But who's coming?
Thank you. I'm counting. So generally, how long does it take to do a song? And I know it's going to kind of vary, but just an idea.
Well, I don't know. I would say maybe we would probably allow one song. We would probably allow 3 days to do. Yeah, because we like to do the writing with the artist rather than us just coming up with it on our own. So it takes a little time to get to know the artist. We like to have conversations with them. Terry's like the psychiatrist. He goes in. He asks all these probing questions that most of the time the artists never think about. And then from that, we begin to kind of shape an idea for a song. And we usually will cut the track. We'll usually do, vocals over a couple of days to make sure some singers sing better right off the bat. Some like to learn the song first. So I would say it's probably maybe a 3-day process to do one song from start to finish. I mean, it can be faster and it can be longer.
Start to finish.
Yeah,
amazing.
Probably 3 days.
Well, you of course are working with some top level individuals who have been trained, who do this for a living, so it's probably going to cut the time in half versus working with someone who's very new in the industry.
Well, and it's not even so much that, but if it's someone who we've worked with before, you know, we can go in and do a song. You know, we've been working with Johnny Gill recently on some stuff, and we can go in with Johnny Gill and do a song in a day easily.
Yeah, a couple hours. Actually.
Yeah, in a couple hours. So, I mean, but we know Johnny. We know what he likes to sing and so on and so forth. So that's easier. And I'm talking about more when it's like a new artist or one, not even necessarily new artist, but maybe an artist that we haven't worked with before.
Mm-hmm.
And then it takes a little time because we like to try to make the song for the artist. We're not into making songs for Jammin' Lewis. We're into making songs for the artist because the artist got to sing the song. If it's a hit song, artist has to sing it for the rest of their life. So we want to make sure that it's something that's, you know, pertains to them and is important to them.
And got that feeling.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, you mentioned Johnny Gill. I'd like to play a piece of one of the songs that you guys worked on with him.
Okay, cool.